school, I hear the late bell ringing. Running through the hall, I hear the glee club singing. Get to the office, I can hardly speak, cause it's the third late pass that I got this week. So to my first class, I run and don't walk. All I hear is my sneakers and the scratching of chalk. And when I get to the room, I hear the teacher say, Mr. Young, I'm happy that you could join us today. I try to sit down so I can take some notes, but I can't read what the kid next to me wrote. And if that wasn't enough to make my morning complete, as I try to get up, I find his gum on my seat. And with the seat stuck to me, I raise my hand and say, excuse me, but can I go to the bathroom, ma'am? The teacher got upset and she screamed out, no, it's off to the principal's office you go. Everybody rushes down to the cafeteria. Picked up my tray that had Thursday's lunch. And when I tried the applesauce, I heard it crunch. I'm running up the stairs with a front tooth broken. The nurse just laughed and said, you must be joking. I looked up at her with a smile on my face. No joke, cause my front tooth is out of place. So I walk through school with ice on my lip. A nurse's late pass like a gun on my hip. My books are real heavy, I walk and I'm dragging it. No school lunch next week, I'm brown bagging it. Forget class, I'ma shoot some ball. With the late pass, I got no trouble at all. But then the nurse walks up and says, what do you know? It's off to the principal's office you go.
The official adventures of the official adventures of
young MC.
The official adventures of
young MC.
The official adventures of
recess.
My favorite pastime. I can't wait to find a girl to pass mine to. To express my feeling, give me a week, me and the girl I be dealing. Now one young lady was looking at me. I said, hi, my name is Marvin, known as Young MC. But then the bell rang and the teacher came in, and that's when the game of passing notes would begin. I wrote the first note, told her she was fine, and I hope that the two of us can spend some time. She wrote me back and told me, you're fine too. I'd love to go on a date and spend some time with you. So then I sat there reeling and looking at the ceiling. Words can't express the way that I was feeling. Then I thought to myself, the sure way to get her is to write another note. Oh yes, a love letter. When I finished the note, it was ready to pass. The teacher took it and read it right in front of the class. She read it word by word and line by line. And everybody who was laughing was a friend of mine. Even my girl was laughing. It was too late. We need to write another note, cause there were